Hey, what is good? My anniversary, what good? Honestly, this whole entire arc looks amazing still, even though it's in the anime form. I honestly don't think anybody who has seen the movie is watching it at this point, besides like people like myself, who just want to see if there's any new things, if there's any elaborations on stuff. Like, is there things that they wanted to add to this? And if there is, what is it? But as of right now, it does not look like that is the case. There was a whole entire talking period from last week's episode in a couple minutes of this episode just to make it run enough time to not show enough new stuff. So I'm getting a really good idea of what they want to do, which is unfortunate, which we'll probably continue to see happening through and through. But regardless, I really do want to see a lot more from my lightning boy. I hope he gets more than one stage where like one form he can do, because if he can do more, bruh, you know how, like, I understand his teacher only taught him one thing and told him to be good at that one thing. My problem is, how hard is it to come up with your own fighting stuff while just in the moment, you know? It feels like something he could easily make himself. But if someone as old and as wide as his master could only teach him one or wanted him to master one, it speaks a lot on the Lightning crew. Because as we see, a lot of the water people who use water styles have the same like outcome, like water wheel, water bison, stuff like that, right? There's certain water techniques that everybody seemingly uses. And if that is the case, then what is it that other lightning people before his grandfather used, or were there none? Because, like I said, the world of Demon Slayer is still relatively not known by a lot of us anime watchers, and I think that is the fun part about this show, is there's still a whole ridiculous amount that they could lay on us, but instead they are doing this movie arc yet again and giving us more reason to understand. Hopefully there's some hype stuff to come, but if not, we're just gonna have to pray and hope we get something cool at the end of the day. So, with that being said, let me know what y'all are thinking. This was a very quick showcase of how capable our Slayers are, even though they needed the help of Rengoku, which I think Rengoku is probably the most broken person we've seen. But unfortunately, I still actually think personally the main strongest person we've seen is the man who's reached more stages than even Tanjiro has reached in his fighting style, the 11th form Dead Calm, you know. So there is so much that I want to know about this whole entire anime. But until then, I hope y'all are having an amazing one. Hopefully season 2 lives up to the expectations a lot of us have, especially now watching this train arc look as amazing as it does. I can only imagine what everything else is going to be looking like here very soon. So, all that being said, take care, everybody, and peace.